This will be a quick video on generating multiple images with a single image of the subject. And this is my subject. And on the right, this is the preview of the different images generated using one image. On the left, there are multiple prompts. Generating three images took around 100 seconds on my 4060 Ti with 16 gigabytes of RAM. There is a slight difference if compared with the original image, but the same workflow worked for my project. As this worked for me, it may also work for someone else. The workflow is simple, and the custom nodes here are commonly used. You can see I have given three prompts, which generated the respective images on a single run. These are not the only prompts I was using. Below are the prompts I needed to generate different poses of the same subject. The prompts are for different angles, and you can change the background as per your needs. Right now, the background is based on my requirement. Similarly, these are for the dark background. And then the nightclub environment, and then the body profile images. The last is for some casual Instagram images with lights around the subject. The model used here is the QuinEdit 2509 FP8 model. You can also use the GGUF model if you have a smaller graphics card. The model links are provided on the left. Clicking on them will direct you to the larger model files. And this is the direct download link to the file I am using. Below is the link to all the GGUF models, which should be kept in the UNet folder. A few days ago, second version of the Lightning LoRa was released. Links are given if you want to try those. I was not aware while working, so I ended up using the older version, and the download link for the same is given. With the Lightning LoRa, I also tried the Nexene LoRa, but the quality felt a bit on the lower side. I will be updating this workflow in a few days with a LoRa, as it will help enhance the overall quality of my results. Next is the text encoder, where I was using the smaller file, and then the VAE. This workflow does not need any explanation, but this part may confuse the new users. The preview image node does not save images. These are the nodes for saving multiple images. This is the prefix added to the image name given to the Save Image node. And below is the folder path where you want to save the images. This is a custom node, and you should be having these KJ nodes already. If not, then install the missing nodes from the Comfy UI Manager. You can bypass these nodes if you do not want to save all the images. Use the right and left arrow keys to preview the next image. Save an individual image by selecting one image and then click Save from the options. The folder name you put here will be created automatically, which makes working with lots of photos easy. You can use this node as well to process multiple prompts. It takes a list from a text node. I am using another node, and the only catch here is you should not leave an empty line like this, or else the image will be processed on an empty prompt. So that's it for this video. Let me know if you found it helpful. If yes, then I will make more short videos like this covering small workflows. I hope you have an excellent day.